Hi all, I'm Emily Madan. I am here to walk you through this expert GMAT problem. So take a few minutes, see what you can make of it, and then we'll discuss. So with a problem at this level, you're always going to have a few different options for how you can solve it. And getting through this isn't so much a question of whether you can get to the answer, but whether you can get to the answer efficiently and effectively. So absolutely, we can do algebra, we can make equations, we can figure out the translations here, but that's probably not the best way to go about this. If you take a look at the answer choices, they are incredibly simple numbers, right? Low, positive integers. And the expressions that we're given, p plus 15, p times 9 minus p, those are not particularly complex expressions. So if I'm going to make a mistake, it's going to be in the algebraic translation. So what I'm going to recommend is no algebraic translation. Instead, let's do what we call working backwards, and let's use these answer choices. So the question is asking, what is p in a certain scenario, right, when we actually make a profit here? That means each of these answer choices, if it's correct, is giving us the value of p. What I can do is imagine that, yes, a is the correct answer. If the answer is 3, then I can easily say p plus 15, which is our first expression up here, is going to be 18. Okay? Absolutely no opportunity for error unless something crazy is going on. So this is going to be very straightforward, and this what I've done here is for answer choice A, I have actually calculated a potential cost. This math is so simplistic that I'm not even going to apply advanced strategy. I'm just going to go down the list and calculate the exact cost for every single answer choice. So if P is 3, the cost is 18. If P is 4, the cost is 19. 5, it's 20. 21, 22. All right, very simple, easy math. There's no chance I made an error there. So now to answer the question, we also need to figure out how much each batch sells for so we can start talking about profit. Now, this is a slightly more complex expression in that I have P showing up twice. So I'm not gonna try to do all of that in one step in my mind. Instead, I'm gonna write this out as P and separately 9 minus P. So if P is 3, 9 minus P is 6. If P is 4, 9 minus P is 5. If P is 5, 9 minus P is 4. Again, very, very easy math. I am very sure I'm not making a mistake. So now the question is, I've got all these values, I've plugged everything into the expression, but how do I translate that into picking an answer? Here's where the logic comes in. It's asking, at what point do we start making a profit? Well, how do you make a profit? You make a profit when your costs are less than your income, or in this case, your sale price. So if your cost less than sale, that's our right answer. And now take a look at what the two columns we've created mean. P plus 15 in the text, it says that that is the cost. So here I have a column of costs. P times 9 minus P, that is our column of sale prices. Okay, so that's what it's selling for. All I have to do is see at what point is the cost less than the sale price. All right, so for A, I'm comparing 18 to 3 times 6. That is 18, so no, that doesn't work for us. For B, I'm comparing 19 to 20. 19 is less than 20. So looking at this, the cost is less than the sale price. I want my cost to be less than sale price. Okay, B's looking pretty good as the right answer. And honestly, on test day, this is enough. I've just proven it is, in fact, the right answer. I'd select this and move on. But everything so far has been relatively quick. If you really want to triple check, sure, go ahead, test the last three answers. So now I have 20 compared to 5 times 4. That's 20. So those guys are going to be the same thing. Not, in fact, the right answer. 21 compared to 6 times 3. Which is 18, 21 is greater than. I've now flipped the inequality. That's the opposite of what I'm looking for. I'm now losing money. And 22 compared to 14, same problem. So here I have proven B is the right answer without having to resort to algebra. It's just simple arithmetic. There's no equations, there's no translations. So what I would recommend is in these scenarios where you have a word problem and you're going to have to create an equation, there's a lot of opportunity for error in that equation creation. Look for different solution paths. Look for opportunities to work backwards and try to avoid introducing that element or that opportunity for error by working backwards. Subscribe for more GMAT Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep and leave a comment telling us how you solved this one. Happy studying.